our Tim Hawk Show sponsors. We're going to turn it over to the public address right now for the National Anthem.
Campbell with a rebound here coming up through 30. Campbell. Going to be
looking for a man. He's just got a team in the corner. He's going to dribble it up top. John Green with it. Four of the crusaders. Scoreless minute and 10 seconds into the Class 2 regional championship game. Ty Campbell gets the ball down low. And the first foul of the game is called on Joey Bowser for trying to win.
Something to watch in this game is foul trouble. Obviously, Joel Campbell.
Foul number four, Joey Campbell.
That's
his first,
James Burke Campbell. So, we'll
watch
that closely.
Now, Jordan inbound from the baseline. Campbell quickly. Yeah! Looks down low for Blaukamp. Blaukamp sees a double turn that's swinging around in the right corner. And that's it's a two-point.
I'm okay with those guys shooting long two-pointers. That's the shot we want them to take. Just don't let them shoot open threes.
Game behind Grant McComb at the top of the circle. Just missed that jump shot a little bit long. Rebound comes down to Cole. Here come the defenders. Cole looking to push it up. Pulls up for a jump shot just inside the 3-point line. Missed it. And Taylor with the rebound for the Crusaders. Taylor down for John Daniels. That about the 3-ball on the right side. They'll swing it back. Tyler Campbell into the paint. Goes off the shot. The Crusaders lead 4-2. Here comes John Unity. The other way. First team. And Unity team. Being guided by the sophomore Lamar Jordan III. It's off of Blaukamp, right at the top of the key, just a second. Two inside the 3-point line. Off of Prisby on the left side, he's going to launch another 3-ball. That one's long. And on the rebound, chased down by Jordan with the Crusaders ball. 5:20 to go here in the first quarter. MCC up 4-2 in the regional championship game. Fred Granja. John Daniel on the right wing. And swing it around. Contesting it, he missed it, and Ty Campbell got the rebound.
Yeah, interesting, not what I expected. Kevin Fallow on Blaukamp, but so far he's done a very good job.
The Coles got it up to the back of Fallow, and the right side, John Daniel. Slide on to the left side, and now Jordan McCoy. Thought about the open shot, still gets the McCoy on the baseline, McCoy driving through the baseline, and then the Coles is grabbing with it. It'll be John Unity ball. 4:14 to go here in the first quarter. MCC up 4-2.
It's okay. And Grant McCollum being aggressive there. I love to see him and Lamar Jordan. When they get the ball, take it to the hoop.
Down low. Blaukamp gets it. Has it knocked out of his hands. Taylor keeps possession. Cole with a three ball from the left side. Missed it. Long rebound. City got Jordan back to Cole. Drops it off for Prisby on the left side. Prince open for three. He launches that one. That one's just short. Rebound pulled down by John Daniel. He's going to get fouled. MCC back. 3:45 to go here in the first quarter. They lead 4-2. And taking a quick look back time. Trey had 13 points in the first quarter. The first quarter was MCC. He just had a first game. Only 2 points on the board of an hour so far. We're halfway through his first quarter.
Very interesting. Trey Unity coming out. Stone Cole from the field.
Daniel gets a bounce from the other. He hits it for two. It's a 6-2-3 lead. Here comes Blaukamp the other way. Pushing it out for driving the defense. It back to Prisby. He will set up the offense. Crusaders go on the man defense. Blaukamp's got it on the left side. Down low. Finds Blaukamp. To go here in the first quarter. Joey Blaukamp with a bucket and he'll step to the free throw line.
He's a well-coached team. He comes from the outside, so what do? They just push the ball inside the back.
Blaukamp's free throw is second straight through. MCC's lead trimmed to 1. 6-5 with 3:14 to go here in the first quarter of play. Adam Carroll will bring the ball up for the Crusaders.
Thank you.
Championship game, Muskegon Catholic and Tri-Unity all tied up. 12 apiece here to start the second quarter. Crusaders get the ball. And Paul will bring it up, give it to John Daniel on the left side, Clark Campbell with it. And swing it out for Daniel on the right. Daniel looking down low, drives to the basket, pulls up his dribble, he's going to kick it back out of the top for Carlo. Carlo reset the offense for the Crusaders. Places through the lane, Grant McCollum gets open, he's at the top of the key with it. After Daniel, after Carlo. McCollum slices through the lane, John Daniel gets it, Daniel. With the screen from Carlo, finds McCollum in the right corner, but after Carlo, and this is a nice goal in the third.
No need for the Crusaders to rush right here. Get a good shot.
Carroll gets a screen for Campbell. The swing in, and that's a good down low for Campbell. It's a good hit.
Again, you know, teams sometimes panic in this situation. The defensive team's fans get on their feet. But hey, they're not scoring either. So.
Left to go here in the second quarter. We're tied up 12-12. We'll be back on Country 93.1. Just a 30, John.
Here's ESPN talking about that, making a lot of pressure, looking against the big boys. We've talked about it a lot, but how far Ian Tyler, Eric Van Fossen, and Todd Hall have come. Big three. Six, the first free throw.
Camp
who came out and played. Pocket missed the bunny, but Octor with the rebound. Gets it off to McCollum in the corner from the elbow. Kari Campbell launches it.
Wow, this has been a great game so far. A critical final 2 minutes of the half. MCC's played so well, they can't let Triunity get a spurt.
Frisbee gets a screen from Blaukamp, comes to the right hand side, thought about going back, instead takes it to the bucket, missed it long, rebound, comes away with it. Frisbee over for Cole, gets it back, and here a reset. The defender offense, Jesse Anderson on Frisbee. Frisbee for Prince on the left side. Kari Campbell out on Prince right now.
Interesting.
Prince is going to match up with someone. Prince hands it off for Frisbee up top, covered by Jesse Anderson. Frisbee on the left side. Cole's going to pull up the jump shot for short. Brent McCollum with a rebound for the Crusaders. He's going to get it. The Crusader ball is a minute 12 to go here in the first half. That'll be Clint.
Ball number 15, play Fred, just to the second.
You see, guys, these football players like Jesse Anderson and Brant McCollum and Lamar Jordan, Kari Campbell, they're not going to be intimidated by anybody or back down from anybody.
Adam Campbell will bring the ball up here to the Crusaders. Minute 5 to go here in the first half. 20-20, all tied up in the Class D Regional Championship. Campbell over to Brant McCollum, gets it back. Crusaders again in no hurry to set up this offense. Double team, Frisbee took it up on the left side. Cole thought about the three, drives to the basket. He's going to get fouled after the shot. And they're on two free throws coming up to the 3.9 seconds remaining. Kari Campbell is going to be the guilty player for the Crusaders. That is his second foul of the game, so the Crusaders have to watch that. This free throw is up and through for Daniel Cole, giving his team back the lead. Got one more shot coming up. Second free throw rims out, so it's a 21-20 lead for Triunity. 40 seconds remain here in the first half of play. Adam Campbell brings it up for MCC. Looks over for Brant McCollum. He's trying to pick that one off too. Adam Campbell over for John Daniel. Daniel back for Campbell. 25 seconds left. Open for three on the left side. That one just came out. Frisbee to rebound. 12 seconds left. Frisbee brings it up. That's Joey Blaukamp. Blaukamp open against Kalla. Kicks it off. Walker wide open for three. That one rims out. Kari Campbell with a rebound. 3 seconds left. 2 seconds. Campbell launches a three ball. No good.
Maybe in that corner.
All right, you guys are doing great.
So No Shave November, you just kept it going, huh?
Yeah, I can't stop.
Amazing. Have you had it since then?
Yeah.
It's going to go soon.
All right, you guys are awesome.
Good to see you, man.
He's made a presence on the scoreboard, but he's not running away off to a 30 or 40 point night either.
Yeah, it's very interesting. You know, we expected Grant McCollum and maybe even Charlie Campbell to draw the assignment of plow camp, but it's been Adam Callow. He's been playing very fundamentally sound defense, and I think some of the matchups that Lamar Jordan came up with were surprising to Mark Pilo.
Catholic Central trailing by one here in the regional championship game against Tri-Unity. While we take our final 3 minute break, and we'll come back with the second half of play here in Granville High School, Country 93.1. Jordan, and what I call Lamar Jordan III. finds Kari Campbell slicing through the lane. Off the glass, for two. Kari Campbell gives a crusader. And the free throw could make it a 2-point win.
Hasn't had the inch with Kari Campbell. The only guy strong enough out there to cover him is Blau Camp, and they don't want to put him on yet.
Campbell hits the free throw. It's 23-21 MCC.
14 points for Kari Campbell to lead all scores.
Evan Kirby will bring the ball over for the defender. Gets on the right side, gets it off the floor. Back up top for Blau Camp. Down low looking for Walker. Back door across the finish. To his team as Anacalo crosses through, off in the palm on the right side, tackled by Daniel, knocked away from behind. Can't come away with it, here comes Kyrie. Blanco at the free throw line. Picks up his dribble, gives it back to Daniel Cole. Cole working with John Daniel, takes it into the lane. Cole missed the two, rebound, put down by Walker momentarily with Kari Campbell. Comes away with it for MVP. Daniel got on his knee, hands it off to Jordan, and here come the Crusaders. For Brant McCollum, back for Callow on the left wing. Up top for Lamar Jordan. Jordan to the elbow, back for McCollum. And Brant McCollum. Getting off to Daniel, who soon will set up there on the floor. Drives to the baseline, gets a pick up for Kari Campbell. Into the lane, down low for Lamar Jordan. Gives a pass to the foul. Will have a three throws coming up for MCC. Crusaders stay patient.
MCC looks best when the offense runs through Kari Campbell.
Ball number 24, Matt Walker. That's his 14th second.
The sophomore Lamar Jordan, for his first points of the night, hits the first free throw. They'll make it a 24-25 MCC lead. One more free throw coming up for Lamar Jordan, third. Dribbles and he carries that one. It's 25-21. MCC matches their biggest lead of the game at 4 points. And Frisbee brings it up. They're trying to lock on the right side. Cole will turn it back around. Frisbee open for three in the left corner. Missed it again. Kari Campbell with the rebound. And it's knocked away from behind by Cole, but Messler is going to get it back. They drive it to the basket, kick it back, Walker, long jump shot, Collins long rebound, Lamar Jordan the third, long pass up for Brant McCollum, McCollum lays it off the glass, just missed that one, and it's not going to do it, and here comes Kyrie, off with Cole on the left side, off with Kyrie, off with Kyrie, off with Kyrie, off with Kyrie, slow it down momentarily, swing, fire from the elbow, short on the jump shot, and it could have gone back over the back, rebound, off the glass, all the way back. John Daniel down low for Campbell. Campbell off the glass. What's in there? It's 27-21 at
MCC. MCC coaching staff really excited. Kari Campbell's feeling it.
Cole gets a screen to the left side. Watches the shot. Going to get a foul. What a foul. I think it's going to go on Kari. For MCC, that'll be his third foul of the game. It is. Five and a half minutes to go here in the third quarter. Crusaders got a decision to make. Ian Tyler is going to come in for Kari Campbell. 4:37 to go here in the third quarter. Cole misses the first free throw for Tri-Unity. David Mason, Walker, and Prince will get a free hit. He's just about
this class of East Regional Championship game.
Basket.
Basket.
It sure looked like he was on the line. It sure looked like a blocker.
Regional Championship game in Berkeley open for three. And just one down. Larry Thornton pulls down the rebound.
Corner, and he's going to throw it off Crispy, and bounds, it'll be MCC ball on the sideline. I didn't know better, I almost him. And it feels that way a little bit in the last few minutes. To the basket off the glass, and they'll have two free throws as he just missed his shot.
Foul number 24, Matt Walker. That's his second.
Okay, well, he just does not have the answer. Yeah, I see that. Everything looks good on my side. Thank you.
for Lamar Jordan. Jordan back to John Daniel. Daniel's going to get fouled by Cole. And the MCC ball out of bounds with 5:44 to go here in the fourth quarter.
Ball game 33-32.
My apologies for the technical difficulties. And due to these technical difficulties, you don't get to hear the wonderful tones of Tom Thunder's voice.
Go on
Matt Walker and Grant McCollum.
take a quick 30-second break. We'll be back with more here on Country 93.1. Yes, sir. Well, the air card is on, yes. Second attempt. Again, four free throws four dribbles for Kyrie Campbell, and the free throw is up and through. 4-point lead. 2 minutes to go. First of all, Jordan and Harry between the post and defense here. Frisbee brings it up to a 30-second timeout. MCC
get these nappy go-karts issues full of crap.
Coming up for Joey Blaukamp.
Camp's second free throw. Sorry, Campbell, the rebound. Crusaders lead is three. Campbell getting out of MCC. And he's going to call timeout as he moves midcourt. He will take a great take a 60-second break as well with 1:16 to go here in the fourth on Country 93.1. All right, John, I should be streaming again. Everything says I'm streaming the primary right now.
Tri-Unity defenders.
MCC ball. They lead by two with a minute left. And they're going to get fouled in the backcourt. And two free throws are coming up for the Crusaders. Looks like it's going to be Ian Tyler stepping to the free throw line. Daniel Cole, the guilty party on the foul. That is the last foul of the game. Ian Tyler stepped in a little bit earlier and split a pair of free throws, shooting for Brant McCullough. He missed the first one here. And now they're coming out with a minute left. 1 minute left to go here in the fourth quarter. Second free throw is off the mark. Left with the rebound. He's going to put it down. Gary Blaukamp will bring it up for the defender. Blaukamp takes it straight to the basket. Raiders with the ball in their hands. 52.7 seconds remaining. Kyle Campbell will inbound it to Adam Kyle. Kyle, after John Jordan, Brandon crosses midfield with 47 seconds left. It's a back for Kyle. With the time, now they're holding the ball for UCC. 38 seconds left. Campbell has stepped to the free throw line. Now, Coach Lamar Jordan was trying to use his last timeout, but the foul happened right before he fired it. So Daniel Cole is out of the game for John Hudy. Larry Campbell has stepped to the free throw line for the Crusaders. He has two free throws coming up with 15.6 seconds remaining.
Eight on the day. It's about 5-9.
on 60-second timeout before Campbell's second free throw attempt. 11.4 seconds remaining. Crusaders up 47-45. We'll take a 60-second break from Country 93.1. Yeah, are you there? Everything's going okay on the screen? Okay, well, we'll stay back into the screen then.
Strange.
Absolutely. Hopefully it's a highlight. They're up by two. They got one more free throw left. 20 seconds. That's what they're doing.
Absolutely.
Crusader. Mark Hamill backing down. Joey Blauschamp draws the foul. Foul of the game for Blauschamp. He got one early guarding Campbell, now gets one in the overtime set. Five dribbles for Tariq Brown. Free throw is up off the front.
Thank you.
2.5 seconds remaining. Go on Mark Jordan. That is his fourth foul. Crusaders now with three starters with four fouls each, as well as Grant Cullen on the bench. Fouled out. 52.5 seconds remaining as Bobcat steps to the free throw line. First free throw is up and through. Crusaders have no timeout, so they did get one. They got one near the overtime session. That's a free throw for Bobcat. He's up. Frisbee as time expired in regulation to force this extra session.
Box out shooter!
Campbell's free throw is up and through. It's a two-point game. The Crusaders will look to foul, and they get it in. And Wildcats will be fouled with 12 seconds left, so just a half a second. It works off the clock.
Gotta make a play on the
ball. And now Jordan. This game for the Crusaders. So Anderson will have to check in. Joey Wildcats will step to the line.
Fatigue has got to be a factor. He has really been pounded on both ends of the court.
Coach Lamar Jordan wants his team to come over as they have 60 seconds to replace his son. Lamar III who has fouled out of this game. Dave Van Fossen is going to be the man called to step in for MCC.
We talked about these guys early in the year, Ian Tyler, Eric Van Foss, and Todd Hall. They've grown and matured so much. Can they come through here at the biggest point of the season?
If Blackhand gives them a chance first, the free throw goes off the mark. So the biggest lead Triune can have is 3 points. John Daniel telling everyone to box out. 12 seconds remain. We're in overtime. MCC, no timeouts.
To throw the ball to the end of the court to let time run out, and it ended up being a foot race. Curry won it.